Welcome to a lesson on multiplying fractions using paper folding. In our first example, we have 1/2 times 1/3, which means we want half of a copy of 1/3. So we'll begin by modeling the fraction 1/3, and we'll assume one sheet of paper equals one whole. So for 1/3, we would fold or partition the paper into three equal pieces. In this case, it's been done vertically. We would shade one of the three pieces to represent 1/3. Now, because we want half of a copy of 1/3, we'll now fold or partition the paper into two equal pieces. And because for 1/3 we folded the paper vertically, we'll now fold the paper horizontally into two equal partitions. So we'd fold the paper along this line here and then shade half. So if we shade the upper half red, it would look like this. And this double shaded region represents the product of our two fractions. Notice how by folding the paper vertically into three equal partitions and horizontally into two equal partitions, we've divided one whole into a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 equal partitions, which should be the denominator of our product. And only one of those partitions is double shaded, which means our product is 1/6. Notice how by shading 1/3 vertically and 1/2 horizontally, this double shaded region represents one half of the blue region, which was 1/3. So 1/2 of 1/3 is this yellow region, or this double shaded region, which is a total of 1/6 of one whole. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have 1/3 times 3/4, which means we want 1/3 of a copy of 3/4. So we begin by modeling 3/4. Notice how here we folded the paper horizontally first into four equal partitions, and we shade three of their partitions to model 3/4. Now, because we want 1/3 of a copy of 3/4, we'll now fold or partition the paper vertically into three equal partitions. So we'd fold the paper along this line and along this line. Because we want 1/3 of a copy of 3/4, we would shade one of these three partitions, which I've done here in red, and therefore the product will be the fraction represented by the double shaded region, or these three partitions here. Notice how we have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 equal partitions, which make up one whole, three of which are double shaded. Therefore, our product is 3/12. Again, notice how by folding the paper horizontally into four equal partitions and vertically into three equal partitions, it gave us a total of 12 equal partitions. And because this region here represented the fraction 3/4, and we wanted 1/3 of 3/4, notice how if we divide this into three equal partitions, and take one of the three partitions, this is the same as the double shaded region, which is 3/12 of one whole. But notice if we consider this bottom region here, these three partitions, we now have one whole divided into four equal partitions, each consisting of three smaller partitions. So we could also represent our product as 1/4. It's a little harder to see in this model because notice how for these three partitions, the smaller partitions are stacked vertically, and for this partition, they're stacked horizontally. But 1/4 is equivalent to 3/12. We would say that 1/4 is a simplified form of 3/12. Notice how the fraction 3/12 does share a common factor of 3 between the numerator and denominator. I hope you found these two examples helpful.